Migration Association of North America is a thriving organization advancing the scientific knowledge and promoting the conservation of raptor populations through study, enjoyment, and appreciation. While the organization has grown and expanded its mission, HMANA was established in 1974 when a small amount of hawk watchers from across North America first gathered in Syracuse, New York.
Mike Harwood was probably the most important person in the creation of the organization. He wrote the book View from Hawk Mountain. He was part of the Hawk Mountain group, although he lived in Connecticut. And he had the idea of bringing together hawk watches, and he controlled the invitation list, and it was his idea to announce the creation of a new organization at this first conference. The original meeting, where the concept of creating a network of hawk watches was introduced, it was a planning meeting for the first hawk migration conference, and it was held actually in my house. I didn't chair that meeting, I didn't organize that meeting. That was done by Mike Harwood and the Hawk Mountain people. They are the people that deserve the lion's share of the credit. So Hawk Mountain is really where HMANA came from. They're the godfather of the organization.
In addition to Hawk Mountain, the Connecticut-based founders of the New England Hawk Watch were also instrumental in organizing that early conference and the new HMANA organization. While HMANA continues to focus on its foundational mission, the organization has also expanded to include creating a formal network of observers throughout North America, standardizing the recording, storage, and sharing of empirical data. They also educate the public about birds of prey and their role in the world's environment, develop improved methods of estimating bird of prey species populations, and identify and assess fluctuations of these populations.
At first at the HMANA, we didn't have that much of a concern with educating the general public. First, we had to get more hawk watches established and a higher quality of hawk watcher. And that was our emphasis at first. It wasn't that we were going to ignore that, and the organization now does have someone identified for that role and is looking into it. But it really wasn't a focus at first. It was a sort of feeling we had to walk before we could run.
Through HMANA, other focused organizations, and hawk watchers around North America, the sharing of data, knowledge, and techniques has advanced hawk watching into a high-quality, standardized system of counting. These techniques reveal habitat and ecosystem changes by monitoring spring and fall migration.
One big difference right away that you notice when you look at the old newsletters compared to the current observations is that there's many more sites for hawk watching, and the quality of the hawk watchers really improved a lot, in my opinion at least. And that's terrific. If you look at the older ones, like the ones I was when I was editor, you often had particular days reported, not season totals, because there were so few days being watched. You also see how bad the situation was back in the early 70s, still from DDT. There's in the Atlantic Coast region, there was that Bill Clark reported on, there was a total of 3 peregrines seen that year. 3! You know, they'll get 100 in a good day now. So the peregrines have rebounded beautifully, and of course so.
Every hawk watcher has their own list of fond memories at their local watch or experiences traveling to see hawks around North America. The enjoyment of migration, the individual species, their behaviors, and time in the field with fellow birders is what brings the human enjoyment to hawk watching.
In the first week of November, which is one of my favorite times to go hawk watching, you don't get as many birds, but boy, the quality you get with golden eagles and goshawks and rough-legged hawks. And way in the distance, we spotted 2 birds fighting. They were just barely specks, and they came right above us. They slowly came in, right in real close. And it was 2 rare birds. It was a rough-legged hawk and a raven. And they were so angry at one another. The raven doing the funny clucky noises, and the I could only describe it as a scream that was done by the rough-legged, and they were so angry at each other that the watchers there, about 25 of us, broke out in laughter. I never saw a hawk watch break out in laughter before or since.
HMANA has seen steady growth since its inception in the mid-1970s, but the organization continues to grow today and now includes paid staff, an engaged working board of directors, and office space on the horizon. HMANA wishes to thank Eric Singel and the many others involved in the creation of this great organization. We find great pride in continuing this important mission well into the future.
Oh, I want to acknowledge Mike Street for having thought of this in the first place, and not many people were aware that I was involved in the founding of HMANA, people I've been watching hawks with, so it was nice sort of to get that, you know, Mike knew about it and gave me that recognition and arranged for this. I appreciate it very much, and it was nice to get to know you, John, and the new president of HMANA. It's just, you know, I'm just so happy to see the organization doing so well, and I can't believe they're actually going to get a building now, too. That's absolutely great. Thank you.